Hi guys, welcome to Bevywise IoT Simulator tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect the IoT simulator to a MQTT cloud server. Okay, so here I'm using Bevywise IoT platform as a MQTT cloud server. Okay, so first you must give the MQTT cloud server credentials in the simulator settings. Okay, for that, click the settings icon on the top right corner. Here in broker details, you must give the MQTT cloud server credentials. Okay, so first in manager application, you must choose Bevywise IoT platform. Suppose if you are using any other MQTT cloud servers other than Azure or AWS, you can choose others. Okay, so now I'm choosing Bevywise IoT platform. So in broker IP address, you can give the IP address of the MQTT cloud server or endpoint, or you can give the domain name. So here I'm giving Bevywise IoT platform domain name. Okay, next one is the TLS and SSL. Suppose if your cloud server is running in TLS and SSL, you can enable this and you can change the port. Okay, so this is the default TLS SSL port. Suppose if your broker is running in different ports, you can edit this. Okay, next one is the root certificate. So you can download the root certificate from your cloud server and you can upload it here. Next one is the clean section. So here you can enable the clean section by giving it as 1, or you can disable it by 0. Okay, so based on your requirement, you can give the clean section. So once done, click save to save the configuration. Next, if your MQTT cloud server is running with device level authentication, okay, you can enable the authentication here and give the MQTT username as access key and MQTT password as an access token. Okay, so here our IoT platform is running with device level authentication. So you can copy the MQTT username and paste it in the access key and click save, and copy the MQTT password and paste it in the access token and click save. Like this, you must enable authentication for all the devices and copy paste the MQTT username and password. So these are the configuration you must do to connect the IoT simulator to the MQTT cloud server. Okay, so next we must start the simulator. Okay, to start the simulator, click the red button on the top right corner. Okay, so this button will use to start the whole network. Suppose if you want to start the device one by one, you can click the red button next to the device. Okay, so now I'm going to start the network. You can see the red button is turned to green color. So this means the IoT simulator is connected to the MQTT cloud server. Okay, and you can also see the published messages in the device log. Okay, and here we have a overall dashboard. Here we will show you the total number of devices, active devices. Okay, and also the total number of subscribed topic and published topic. And here also we have a network log which will show you the overall log of the network. Okay, here the orange color means the subscriber data, green color means publisher data. Okay, so like this you can connect the IoT simulator to any MQTT cloud server. Okay, so these are the steps to connect the IoT simulator to a cloud server. Hope this will help you guys. For more videos, subscribe our channel. Bye. Thanks for watching.